Hello friends, namaste, welcome to my channel, let's make it lovely. If you are new to my channel, please subscribe and click on the bell icon for notifications. Few of the viewers have been asking me to make a simple housewarming puja backdrop, so let's get started. I got this pre-cut wooden craft sticks from Amazon. I will leave all the product details and links in the description box below. If you are going to be hanging any heavy garlands or planning to make a bigger backdrop, you can use small nails and hammer them together. But I am using lightweight bead strings and cardstock paper for this backdrop, so I went ahead and used hot glue gun to stick this frame together. Once you join the four sticks together and make a square, now using measuring tape, mark the sticks at equal length. Because these sticks are 36 inches long, I marked them at 9 inches, 18 and 27 inches. Repeat markings on opposite side too. And stick the three sticks horizontally along the markings. Next, turn the frame other side and mark the top and bottom side at equal distance again. Now, when sticking vertical sticks, make sure you stick them at every joint as shown. Don't skip gluing the joints as this is going to make the frame little stronger. As I'm planning to use only cardstock papers and bead strings for the inserts, it'll be perfectly fine to stick it with the glue gun. If you are planning to make anything heavy on this frame, just make sure you use nails and hammer. Now this is how our frame looks. Next, let's get started with our lotus flower cutouts. First, I printed a free lotus outline from Google Images onto a cardstock paper and cut it out using an X-Acto knife. You can also use a regular utility knife as well. I will leave the link to this lotus image in the description box below, and I'll also add instructions on how to print this onto a cardstock paper. Now using this as a template, we are going to trace the lotus on the back side of the gold foil cardstock sheets. Using some tape, I'm sticking the cardstock sheet onto the cutting mat. It is always safe to use cutting mat so you don't damage your furniture or floor. Make sure you place the template such that center of the flower is at around 4.5 inches from the top, so that it can be centered in our 9x9 frame squares. Now cut out along the traced picture using X-Acto knife. It might look hard to do this step, but because these flowers are small, I could trace and cut each flower in about 5 to 6 minutes. Using a measuring scale, mark 9 inches on both sides and cut out the extra cardstock at the bottom. You can definitely save these gold cut lotus flowers for future decorations too. Next, for the flower strings, I used these red flowers and white beads I have. I actually threaded these using transparent thread, but I'm showing here with light yellow thread so you can see what I'm doing in this video. Take longer thread than you think is necessary. Thread your needle and to the open end of the thread, add your first bead and knot it in place. Knot it multiple times as we don't want all the beads to be falling out later. Next, add a flower, one more bead and then a flower. Because my flowers were small, I added two flowers in each string. Continue stringing the beads until you reach the desired length of 8.5 inches. You can also use pre-made pearl strings like these and just hot glue your flowers to it. After reaching the desired length, knot the last bead in place multiple times and take out the needle. Make sure you have extra thread at this end so that you can tie it to the frame later. I used 5 strings in each square, so I made 40 strings like this and 8 lotus cutouts. Now tie the flower strings to the frame in alternate squares. Here is a tip, in case any of your bead strings have less thread and you are unable to tie it to the frame, just add some extra thread to the last bead and use it to tie it to the frame. Add 5 strings in each square and make sure you tie the strings in alternate squares. Add the lotus cutouts in remaining squares using heavy duty tape. I taped it along all the 4 corners and sides. Because the cardstock I got is 8.5x11 size, they fell little short in 9x9 squares, but it is not that noticeable in the end. Go ahead and stick all the lotus cutouts. You can also use hot glue gun to stick the lotus cutouts. This is how beautiful the frame looks. First, I tried using maroon color fabric for the backdrop. Though I really liked how elegant it looks, flowers at the end of bead strings were not shown at all. So I decided to make alternate color pattern of maroon for lotus cutouts and yellow for the rest. For this, I cut out little squares of maroon fabric to stick them at the back of the lotus cutouts. You can use some blouse piece fabrics you have, or you can even use maroon color cardstock papers. You can just use regular fabric scissors to do this, but I'm just using my fabric rotary cutter to make it easy. After cutting the squares, I stuck them to the back of the lotus cutouts using hot glue gun. Just stretch out the fabric a little bit while sticking to avoid any wrinkles. Now with the help of pushpins and ribbon, I hung my yellow sari for the backdrop. If you can't pushpin or nail your walls, check out my video on how to hang backdrop cloth without drilling walls in the description box below. Now I put the wooden frame on table and added torans and flower garlands using pushpins. Now your simple yet elegant backdrop is ready for puja. Let me know in the comments whether you like yellow color for backdrop or plain maroon backdrop. Hope you liked this video. Please check out my Indian traditional decorations playlist for more such puja decorations and event decorations. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe and share.